In this video, we're going to generate random numbers in Excel, including unique random numbers in Excel. By the end of the video, we're going to get to the point where we're going to create a function called randUnique, and we're going to type a lower boundary for this, let's say starting from 4, an upper boundary, let's say 12, and then we're going to say how many numbers we want to generate. So if I do 5, this will generate 5 numbers between 4 and 12. And there it is, random 5 numbers, just like that. So if we go here and type something else, that should regenerate and give us another 5 random numbers between our low number of 4 and high number of 12. And this is how it's going to work. Now, that function does not exist in Excel, randUnique, but I've made that function under Name Manager up here, and that's what we're gonna do in this video. So first, let's just figure out how we're gonna create a random number in Excel, right? So if I just wanted to generate a random number, I could have just done rand or rand between, that creates a single number. But if you want multiple numbers generated, then you use rand array. It creates an array of random numbers. So if I go ahead and do this and do a row number, so for a row number, that basically in our instance would mean how many numbers we want generated. So if I want 10 random numbers, I would do 10, comma. Then we have the second argument, which gives us how many columns of numbers we want to generate. In this case, I'm going to do one column of numbers, comma. And then we have the minimum and maximum boundaries for our random numbers. So if I do something like 1 to begin with and 40 as the highest boundary, so a number between 1 and 40, if I close parentheses right now and hit enter, you will see we can generate a random number between 1 and 40. Now, this doesn't guarantee we're going to get a unique number. It's just random 10 numbers in this case. So if I update this to, say, 5, we're going to get random 5 numbers. Again, there's no guarantee it's going to be unique. And then there's also this last argument here after comma to make sure that the number generated is actually an integer rather than a decimal point number. So we can do true as the last argument. If I hit enter, see we get 5 numbers. And as you can see in this particular instance, I got 2 14s, so they're not unique, but we got these numbers. So that's our rand array, and if you don't care about your numbers being unique, this should be good enough. You could just generate your list of numbers like this and you're done. Now we want unique list of numbers. So for that reason, I'm gonna start by using another function here, sequence. And sequence just generates a list of numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So imagine if I wanted to generate numbers between 1 and 200, I would type 200. As number of rows. If I close parentheses and hit enter, this will give us starting from 1, and then if I just keep scrolling down, let's do control down really quickly, up to 200. So we generated a list of numbers from 1 to 200. Let's just make this a little smaller. Let's do 40. So now we're going from 1 through 40, like this. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go next to this and generate another random list of numbers. So I'm going to do this rand array function I did before, and I'm going to use the same number of lines I have here. So I got, see, 40 here. So I'm going to do 40 for this too. And then I'm going to basically close parentheses and hit enter. And what this is going to do, it's going to generate 40 rows of random numbers for us here, just like that. So it's going to match this first sequence. So at this point, if I just sort these two columns by this randomly generated numbers columns, I'm gonna get a list. So let me show you what I mean. So if I just select this list here, comma, and then say sort by column number 2, column index being 2, if I hit enter, that's going to, let me zoom out a little bit, so that's going to basically just sort this by this column up here. And what that means, it's going to shuffle these numbers between 1 and 40 in some random order. So we got, see, like these numbers. So at this point, if we wanted like five numbers, we could just grab this first five, and it should give us five numbers between 1 and 40. So how do we now combine all of this different steps to one step? So what we could do, we could just go back here. See, now here I have two separate functions for A column and B column. I'm going to go ahead and grab this RandArray function and cut it out of here without equal sign. And I'm going to go to this other first function here. I'm going to use hStack function, which is going to horizontally stack our two arrays next to each other. So what that means, I'm gonna go after this first function, do a comma, and paste that second function I used to have that used to generate 40 random numbers, like this, close parentheses, hit enter, and now I got one function that generates this range or array of two columns. Which means now I can just take this whole thing and put that inside of a sort function, like so, and then go after this comma and say sort this thing by the second column, like that. Close parentheses, hit enter. Now it's gonna be this. I can get rid of all of that. And now we got one function here that gives us all of this. It gives us all of these numbers generated and then sorted by the second column. And every time we update, this order is gonna shift. Okay, so fair enough. So now we need to grab X number of values here. Let's say we want the first five or something like that, right? So to do so, we're gonna go here and use index function. So I'm gonna do index, close parentheses, put this whole array inside of it, go after this, do a comma, and then I need to grab the first five values. And the way you could do that is by having an array like this, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like five values like this. If I do this, I close parentheses and hit enter, you'll see it grabs me the first five values in there. But I don't want this to be hard-coded, because if this was like 15 numbers, then I have to do this semicolon and keep doing this. So instead of doing this, we can just use another sequence function here. So we can just say sequence, if I just learn how to type that correctly without hitting enter, there it is. We're gonna then type that number, 5. So if we type 5, it's gonna generate between 1 and 5, that array. Or if I type 10, it's gonna go 1 to 10. So this way, we just have this, and it gives us 5 numbers between, in this case, 1 and this upper limit being 40. Now, if I change this 40 to, say, 60, then it's gonna give us 5 numbers, and if we do 60 here, we also have to do 60 here, by the way, to match them. So if both of these are 60, now it's going to generate 5 random numbers between 1 and 60. If I hit enter, that's exactly what we're going to get. If we want more than 5, we can update this to, let's say, 8 numbers between now 1 and 60, and that is going to generate that list. So this is pretty much our core functionality that we need. Except that right now, our boundary starts from 1 and it goes up to 60. So we don't set a minimum and upper boundary. We just basically have upper boundary only. And then we also have this upper limit, and that's it. So how could we make this in a way that we can have a lower boundary and upper boundary? So for that, we're going to use a couple of things. We're going to convert this to a lambda function, first of all. So by using a lambda function, we're gonna be able to later then create a named function, so it's easier to use this function. And then it's also gonna allow us to basically pass some arguments and use those arguments in this function. So first of all, let's just go here and after equal sign, basically put this whole thing, I'm gonna just push this right a little bit, I'm gonna put that whole thing inside of a lambda function. And for this lambda function, I want three parameters. I want the low boundary, I want the high boundary, the highest number, the lowest number, and then I want how many numbers I want generated. So we can just call this limit or count or whatever you want to call it. So I guess I'm going to call it limit, comma, and those are three parameters I want to pass to this function. The way I'm going to use those parameters, first of all, I'm going to then have this index function that I had as the calculation. So I'm going to go after this whole thing and close parentheses. So this is now going to be my lambda function. And in this lambda function, we would pass those parameters. So if I just wanted to do it right here so we can test it, I can open another set of parentheses here and just pass my numbers. So let's say I want this to be between 1 and 60, and then I want 8 numbers like this. So this is the way we're going to run this function. And to be able to modify these numbers, we need to pass those here within this calculation with it. So instead of the 60 I did here, I'm going to use this high, which is the 60 parameter. So I'm going to type high here, and I'm going to type high on this one. And then instead of this 8 right here, I'm going to use that third parameter up here, which is the same as the third parameter here, which is limit. Like that. And notice that right now I did not use that low parameter at all so far. So I'm going to keep it at this. Let's just see what happens before we continue. I'm going to hit enter. And you can see now I got my numbers. So I still get my generated numbers between 1 and 60 and 8 of those numbers. Now I can go back here and update this 8 right here to say 5. Hit enter. And that's going to generate this. And then I can go back and change this upper limit, say to 20. Now we're going to get 5 numbers between 1 and 20. So if I enter, see we got 5 unique numbers between 1 and 20. So that works. The only thing left for us to do is to incorporate this lower boundary in this whole thing too. So we can also choose what's the lowest number we can do. Because right now this 1 doesn't really do anything because we didn't use this low anywhere here in our calculation. How exactly are we going to do that? If we wanted to generate, let's say, numbers between 4 and 14, let's say this is our lower boundary and this is our upper boundary, we need to figure out how many numbers would that be between 14 and 4. Let's actually make this easier. Let's do between 14 and 4 and 6, not 14, 4 and 6. So if my lower boundary was 4, upper boundary was 6, the numbers I would have would be 4, 5, and 6. So there are 3 possibilities between those numbers. That is the same as doing, let's take this upper boundary, the high, minus the low. Now, high minus the low give us 2, but we want 3 possibilities. So we can add 1 to this, and that will be number of possible numbers we want. So we want 3 possible numbers here. So it's going to be, again, high minus low plus 1, and it's going to give us these 3 numbers. Now, if I use those 3 numbers in my sequence to generate 3 numbers between 1 and 3, that will give me 1, 2, 3. The problem is I want my numbers to start from 4 and go to 6 instead of starting from 1 and 3. And I can do that by going here to the sequence function after I generate from 1 to 3, and I can add to this lower boundary right here. So if I add the lower boundary, the 4 to it, we get 5, 6, 7, which is one more than what I actually need here. So I need 4, 5, 6, but I got 5, 6, 7. So at this point, I can just do minus 1, and that would generate our numbers between this low and high boundaries, like this. So that's the logic we're going to use in this function right here. So first of all, let's just do this part. So what I said we need to do between upper boundary, lower boundary, plus 1. That's how many numbers we need to generate, right? So I'm going to go over here, and right here, instead of just doing the high, which is what I got at the moment, I'm going to do high minus low plus 1. And that same exact thing we're going to do for the second rand array, because we need 2 arrays of the same size. So I'm going to do high minus low plus 1, and that should take care of that part. So it should now figure out how many numbers we need generated in each one of those sequences. And that should give us this, except again, the problem here, this is not going to have this part where we add the lower boundary minus 1 to make sure that our numbers start in the right place, because now our numbers start from 1. And for that reason, I'm going to go after this whole index function right here. So if I look here, see this red parentheses, we have a red parentheses here, which is closing that index function. So I'm going to go after that whole thing and add my low boundary minus 1 to do that offset. So if I hit enter right now, let's actually zoom out a little bit and get rid of all of this stuff. So at this point, now I should have my function. So if you look here, we're generating a number between 1 and 20, and we get 5 of them. So if I update this to generate a number between 11 and 20 and get 5 of these, that's what we should get. See, I got 11 as the lowest number. Let's just type something in different cells so we get some updates. So see, now we get our 5 numbers, and they are going to be between 11 and 20, and it generates those numbers for us. Now, if you want different boundaries, let's say we want between 5 and 25, and we want 10 unique numbers between 5 and 25, we can do this, and that's going to give us, see, 10 numbers. And again, if I just type, so it regenerates that list, that will give us our numbers, again, between this 5 and 25 and 10 of those. So now all we have to do is just take this lambda function and store it as a named function so we can easily use this without having this crazy formula in the cell. So I'm just going to basically not have this calling part, just have this part of this function. I'm going to copy that with equal sign, hit escape. Go to my formulas and go to my name manager. I already made this, but I'm going to make a new one so you can see how this works. So I'm going to go under new. Here, we're going to name this function. So I call it randunique. It's just a function name. And here, we're just going to paste that lambda function, control V, with equal sign and everything. And if I press OK, now we should have this randunique function stored in our spreadsheet, which means I should be able to just go here and do equals randunique and say, what's the lower limit? Let's say 7, and the upper limit, let's say 21, and we want 7 numbers. Numbers between 7 and 21, and we got 7 numbers here. So here we go. We got 7 numbers between 7 and 21. If I want 9 of those, I can do that. We got 9 numbers between 7 and 21. And now we got our function that could be used to generate a unique list of random numbers. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.